Today we will discuss sedimentary rocks. They form from breaking apart or from weathering of other types of rocks such as igneous, metamorphic, or even other sedimentary rocks. It's those external processes that cause the weathering of the rocks and break the rocks up. So think a little bit about what will actually break a rock up. Think about potholes. What actually causes potholes? Well, it has to do with ice and water. When water freezes, what happens? It expands. There's a 9% increase. That expansion can crack rock and creates potholes. Also, biologic factors can also contribute to breaking of a rock. Think of a tree up on a crag in a mountain and the roots breaking the rock apart. But there's another part of weathering, and that's called chemical weathering, and that's caused by water. You may not know this, but water is an acid. It's a weak acid, but it's still an acid. It has a pH of 5.7. Why? Because as the rain falls, it absorbs CO2 in the atmosphere, and that makes the water slightly acidic. And this water, this weak acid, causes rocks and minerals to break apart. Now please note, I'm not talking about acid rain here, which is caused by pollutants that we put into the atmosphere, like sulfuric acid. I'm talking about natural, good old rain. Even before the Industrial Revolution, rainwater was acidic. So we have two types of weathering: mechanical weathering, which is caused principally by water freezing, and chemical weathering, caused by water and the acid nature of rainwater. So what is produced by weathering of rocks? What happens when a rock is weathered? Let's start with a very common rock like a granite. It has several minerals like quartz, feldspar, and maybe some biotite mica. So what's going to happen when we weather a granite? We'll start off with the quartz. Remember, quartz is a very hard mineral. It's 7 on the Mohs scale. So what's going to happen to quartz? It's going to form quartz sand. And quartz sand produces what's called a clastic sedimentary rock. Feldspars, another important mineral in granite. The acid water causes the decomposition of the feldspar, and it causes clay to form. And also you produce ions like sodium and calcium in solution. They basically come out of the feldspar and are carried away by the water. And I think a good analogy for this is to think about a drip coffee maker. If you put coffee into the drip coffee maker, the coffee is like the feldspar. So what happens? The water goes through the coffee and takes out the coffee, which is the sodium and calcium, and takes it away and you drink it. What's left behind are the grounds, which are like the clay. So what happens to the sodium and the calcium when they're carried away in the water? They're carried in the river, they go to the ocean, and what happens in the ocean? The sodium can combine with chlorine, and what does it form? Salt. What about the calcium? The calcium is going to form or be used by various animals and plants to form their shells, like corals and clams, and they produce limestones, which is another very common sedimentary rock. So we have two types of sedimentary rocks: the clastic sedimentary rocks, which are particles of like sand or clay, and then the chemical sedimentary rocks, which are produced by those ions in solution. Now, let's look at some pictures of the different rock types. Here I have a picture of a clastic rock. This is the Navajo sandstone out in Zion National Park. Look at the large crossbedding in this picture. This was produced in a dune setting, on an aeolian or wind dune. You can also find sand grains on beaches, as you can see from this picture of a beach. And here's a picture of a ripple mark caused by water flowing over the sand. Clastic rocks form in many different environments, from rivers to the oceans to the deep ocean. So where do carbonates form? They form in warm, shallow water, like in southern Florida and in the Bahamas. And here are a few pictures of students investigating carbonates forming in southern Florida.